physical and chemical properties of your haloalkanes, we are going to see that. What are the major physical properties and what are the chemical properties of your haloalkanes is there. So the properties today we are going to see that. Right? I've displayed the screen, all of you just go through it. Right. So already yesterday we have seen that preparation methods. What are the preparation methods for haloalkanes? Already we have seen that. Now we are going to see about your physical properties of your haloalkanes, alkali halides. We are going to see that. So let us see that. What are the major physical properties are there? Alkali halides are generally what happen mean colorless in nature. Alkali halides are colorless when pure. However, bromide and iodide develop color when exposed to light. So that means mostly alkali halide. That means here metal and another one halogen will be present in there. So this metal halides are almost what happened mean when it is in pure state, it is colorless in nature. Colorless in nature. When it is in pure state, these metal halides are mostly what happen colorless in nature. But bromide and here iodide, bromine and iodine. So when it is exposed to light, it will show see different colors and all they are exhibiting this takes place. And mostly these metal halides are generally what you are saying means many volatile halogen compounds have sweet smell. So volatile, that means mostly metal halides are what happen means most of the metal halides are volatile nature will be present and the sweet smelling compounds they are exhibiting like aromatic compounds. So aromatic compound, how they will exhibit a sweet smelling, same like that. These metal halides also shows sweet smelling compounds in nature. Right. Next one, see there. What about your melting and boiling points for this metal halides? Metal halides melting and boiling points, what will happen? Let us see that. So methyl chloride. Methyl chloride is nothing but CH3Cl. Next one, ethyl bromide, C2H5Br, C2H5Br. Ethyl chloride, C2H5Cl. And some chlorofluoromethane, that is called CFCs, we call as chlorofluorocarbon, CFC, like that we are calling them. So mostly these compounds are what happen means gaseous in nature, gaseous state only, these components will be presenting there. So methyl chloride, ethyl bromide, ethyl chloride, CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons. So these components are mostly what happen means they are existing in gaseous state at room temperature. They're existing is taking place. Right. Just a second. I think John sir is logged on. Right. So methyl chloride and ethyl bromide and ethyl chloride and CFCs, mostly these components are existing in gaseous state is presenting there at a room temperature. Higher members are liquids or solids. Higher members is nothing but here how many carbons is there? Either one carbon atoms or two carbon atoms only presented these compounds. If more than three carbons will be presenting there, three carbons or four carbons, five carbons like that. So the number of carbon atom lower members are existing like gaseous phase, while higher members of your hydrocarbons are existing like either in solid state will be presenting or else gas liquid state will be presenting there, either solids or liquids. So but your lower members, that mean lower number of your hydrocarbons are what happen means they're mostly they're existing like gaseous phase only they're existing this takes place. So mostly these metal halides are generally what you're saying means polar in nature, right? Polar nature they're exhibiting there. Mostly these components and all. So let us see that once. What is meant by here polar like this? As we already learned that molecules of organic halogen compounds are generally polar. Polar is nothing but it will show here positive nature as well as negative nature they will exhibit. So that compounds are called polar in nature. So polarity is nothing but positive or negative charges they will exhibit. And due to greater polarity as well as higher molecular mass as compared to the parent hydrocarbon, the intermolecular force of attraction are stronger in the halogen derivatives. So intermolecular force of attraction, what happened mean more will be presenting there. So why it is more intermolecular force of attraction will be presenting means due to presence of higher molecular mass is presenting as well as greater polarity will be presenting there. So because of this greater polarity is nothing but it will show your positive and negative charges. Positive and negative charges they're exhibiting means that compounds are called as here polarity like that we are saying there. So that means positive charge is exhibiting as well as negative charges, higher values they are exhibiting, and as well as higher molecular mass is present, molar mass is presenting there. So because of these greater polarity and higher molar mass, so these halogen derivatives will having stronger attractive force will be presenting there. That means dipole or van der Waal force of attraction will be presenting there, right? So that's why what happened means these molecule, that mean alkyl halides will having higher melting and boiling points they will exhibit. Melting and boiling points also what happened means higher will be presenting there. So that only they given, just see there. That's why the boiling points of chlorides, bromides and iodides are considerably higher than those of hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons is nothing but simply they are carbon and hydrogen only presenting there. For example, this is one hydrocarbon. If you are taken here another alkyl halide, we are taken that like this. So which one will be more greater force of attraction will be more polarity will be exhibiting means alkyl halide will show here more greater polarity will be present as well as molecular mass also more will be presenting there. So that's why these alkyl halides will have greater intermolecular force of attraction will be presenting compared to this hydrocarbon chain. So compared to hydrocarbons, what happened means alkyl halides will show higher boiling points they will exhibit. Higher boiling points they will exhibit because it having more molar mass will be presenting as well as polarity, greater polarity nature they're exhibiting. So that's why what happened means these alkyl halides will show higher boiling points they are exhibiting. Next one, see there. The attractions get stronger as the molecules get bigger in size and have more electrons. So attractive force will be presenting means that molecules will become bigger in size. Size and what happened, more will be present, larger size is presenting and have more electrons. Many number of electrons will be presenting there. So just we have to see that order once. What is the order for boiling points? Decreasing order. So decreasing order edhula romba weak ah irukum nu ketna, if you are moving from top to bottom like this, if you are moving from top to bottom in halogen family, so the like fluorides, chlorides, bromides, next iodide. If you are moving down like this, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine like that, if you are moving down means, so boiling points are what happened means here decreasing is takes place. Boiling points are what happened? Decreasing is takes place. So that means atomic size is what happens. Size is gradually increasing there. Size and all what happen? Increasing is takes place. Therefore, the boiling points are gradually what happen means decreasing is takes place. Right. So due to because of your lesser intermolecular force of attraction. So size is larger means attractive force what happen? Lesser will be presenting there. So that's why what happen means atomic size is increasing means their boiling points also gradually decreasing is takes place due to because of weak intermolecular force of attraction. So that is the reason for that. Let us see that. They given some alkyl halides is given. Let us see there one example. This example see there once. Before going to seeing that chart and all once see there once the diagram what they given. First one what they taken here methyl halide is taken. CH3X is taken. Next ethyl halides is taken. This also gases will be there. Next propyl halides is taken. So that means nearly what happened graph under slowly, slowly, step by considerably what happened, it is increasing, this takes place. When it is increasing, carbon, the number of carbon changing, that means molar mass is increasing means their boiling points also what happened, increasing this takes place. So for example, if you are taking here methyl halide, we are taken methyl halide. For example, carbon mass number 12, hydrogens 3 will be there, 3. And for example, chlorine or fluorine, fluorine we are taken, right? Chlorine or fluorine, any one we are taken. So that molar mass what you are taken, 35.5. For example, chlorine, I'm taking that. So 5.10, 40.5 will be presenting there. If you are taking here, ethyl halide is taken. Ethyl halide, two carbons are there. So two carbons, each carbon, what is the mass number? 12. 12 to the 24. Next, how many hydrogens are there? 5 hydrogens are there. For example, you are taking halogen, chlorine only we are taken. So therefore, how much molar mass is present? I mean 14, 6. So that means molar mass and all what happen if the number of carbon atoms are increasing means the molar mass also what happen increasing it takes place. So molar mass is increasing means boiling points is what happen, I mean gradually increasing is takes place. So graphical representation we can easily see here. Graphical representation we can easily identify here. For example, methyl halide and all what happened nearly 300 degrees is there. 300 Kelvin temperature is there. But if you are taking this ethyl halide means more than that will be presenting. The greater will be presenting. That means slightly considerable changes we are observing that. So simply what you are understanding in this physical properties means lower members, that means lesser number of carbon atoms are existing means those are gaseous phases present. If higher members are present in carbon atoms means those are available in either solid formation or liquid formation will be presenting there. And mostly these alkyl halides are volatile nature. Many of the organic compound alkyl halides are volatile nature and sweet smelling compounds they're exhibiting. So mostly these alkyl halides are having greater intermolecular force of attraction will be presenting. Why it is arises here greater intermolecular force of attraction means due to because of greater polarity and higher molar mass. Due to because of greater polarity and higher molecular mass, these alkyl halides will shows greater intermolecular force of attraction will be presenting there. So next point what you are seeing means if the atomic sizes increases, so their boiling points is gradually decreasing. This takes place like fluorine to iodine. If you are moving down means alkyl halides, their boiling points are gradually what happen mean decreasing. This takes place. Therefore, alkyl fluorides will having more boiling point than alkyl chlorides, than alkyl bromides, than alkyl iodide. So that means gradually if you are moving like this order means boiling points are gradually what happen mean decreasing is takes place. And one more thing, if the molar mass is increasing there, molar mass, that means number of carbon atoms are increasing, means their boiling points also, what happened means increasing is takes place. How we are saying, while seeing that diagram model, we can easily conclude in that. Right. So let us see this example once, next one. The boiling points of isomeric haloalkanes decreases with increasing the branching. So isomeric haloalkanes is nothing but isomeric. Isomeric is nothing but, for example, see this structure once. How many carbons are there? 4 carbon atoms are there. And how many hydrogen atoms are there? Mean 9 hydrogen atoms are there. And 1 bromine atom is presenting there. If you are taken this compound, we are taken. So this compound also, what is the molecular formula? Means C4H9. Just a second. And 1 bromine atom is presenting there. So that means the number of carbon atoms and number of halogens will be the same number of atoms will be presenting there. So those compounds are called as your isomeric haloalkanes, like that we are calling there. Right. So these isomeric haloalkanes and all, what happened means, if branching is increasing means their boiling points are gradually, what happened means decreasing this takes place. So this point you have to remember. So the number of branching is increasing means boiling points is gradually decreasing this takes place. So let us see that how we are saying branches means, for example, first compound, this one, see the first one, second, third, like that we are seeing there. Here halogen, which carbon, how many carbon atoms is attaching there? The carbon chain, how it is there, linear manner is presenting there. Linear, straight line looking like that will be presenting. So here there is no branching will be takes place. So there is no branching is there means their boiling point, how much will be there? 375 Kelvin temperature will be presenting there. So the bromine atom, for example, second carbon atom is attaching there. So their boiling point, how much will be there? 364 Kelvin temperature will be presenting there. So the branching and all, what happened? The halogen attaching carbon, 2 carbon atoms, it is binding is takes place. So that case it will show here 364 Kelvin temperature will be exhibiting there. Next one, see there. If you're taken last compound, we are taken that halogen attaching carbon, how many other carbon atoms is binded means 3 other carbon atoms is binding is takes place. That means the number of branchings are increasing means, so their boiling points is gradually, what happened, decreasing is takes place. Decreasing is takes place. Right. Next one, see there. So the boiling points of isomeric dihalobenzenes are very nearly the same. So aromatic compounds also, what happened, mean nearly the same will be presenting their boiling points and all. Right. However, the para isomer have high melting as compared to their ortho and meta isomers. So para isomers are having higher melting points is presenting there compared to ortho and meta isomers. Why means, due to symmetry of para isomers that fits in crystal lattice better as compared to ortho and meta isomers. So symmetrical arrangement and all, what happened means very nearly it is same will be presenting there, ortho and meta isomers. So that's why what happened means their melting points here higher will be presenting in para isomers. Para isomer melting points will be higher will be presenting compared to ortho and meta isomers. So just see the diagram is given clearly, just see there once. For example, this is called ortho-chlorobenzene. This is called meta-chlorobenzene. This is called para-chlorobenzene. So melting points and all, what you are saying, melting points, para-isomer, para-chlorobenzene and all having higher will be presenting there. Compared to this ortho and meta-chlorobenzenes, para-chlorobenzene will having greater melting points will be presenting there. But if you're taking your boiling points, how it is there, completely oppositely will be presenting there. So orthochlorobenzene will having greater boiling points is presenting when compared to this metachlorobenzenes. So ortho and here para position attaching chlorine atoms will having greater boiling points is presenting compared to metachlorobenzene. But your melting points, if you are seeing, means para chlorobenzene will having greater melting points is presenting compared to here ortho and meta isomers. So this is small difference, just you have to remember that. So melting point mattum edhula romba adhigama irukuma nu ketana para chloro halides are having more melting points is presenting, but boiling points romba adhigama edhula irukum nu ketana ortho and meta position will be presenting there. Right, this is about here melting and boiling points for these compounds. Next one, see there a density. So density and all, which compounds will having more density will be presenting, means let us see that bromo iodo and polychloro derivatives of hydrocarbons are heavier than water. So bromo bromine, iodo iodine, and polychloro. Polychloro is nothing but many number of chlorine atoms will be presenting there. So these compounds containing hydrocarbons are having higher density will be presenting there. Higher density will be presenting there compared to remaining components. Compared to here, compared to hydrocarbons. So chlorine, bromine, iodine containing, halogen containing hydrocarbons will having greater density will be presenting there because their molecular mass will be more. So that's why density also, what happened, greater will be presenting there. Either chlorine or bromine or iodine attaching halogens are having greater density will be presenting there. Right. The density increases with increasing the number of carbon atoms. So number of carbon atoms is increasing, means automatically the density also gradually increasing is takes place. For example, see this compound CH3 will be there. So this molar mass and all, what happened here, 24 plus 6, totally 30 will be presenting there. So for example, I'm taking that CH3Cl, I'm taking that. So this one, how much will comes there? 12 plus 3 15, 15 plus 35.5. so therefore density how much will be there? 40.5 will be presenting there, molar mass. So the number of carbon atoms is increasing, means automatically density will be increasing is takes place. Right, not only they given, just see there once again. So this and all compounds is given, density and all, what happened, mean gradually increasing is takes place. 1.336 is there. CHCl3 1.489 is there. CCl4, what happened, 1.595 will be presenting there. That mean number of carbon atoms or halogens will be increasing, means density will be more, will be heavier, will be presenting is takes place. Next one, see there. Solubility. So this haloalkanes and all, whether it is soluble in water or not, means it is a slightly soluble in water, very slightly only it will be solubility is takes place in water. In order for haloalkane to dissolve in water, energy is required to overcome the attraction between the haloalkane molecules and break the hydrogen bonds between the water molecules. So why these haloalkanes are slightly soluble in water, means already we are seeing that haloalkanes are having stronger intermolecular force of attraction is presenting there. If you want to break that intermolecular force of attraction, means it will require your more energy will be required to overcome that force of attraction. So that's why what you are saying, means haloalkanes are here slightly it will be soluble in water molecule. Right, next one, see there. Less energy is released when a new attractions are set up between the haloalkanes and water molecule. So that means water molecule and here haloalkanes, if you want to break this bond, means what happened, means more energy will be required. So that's why these metal halides, alkyl halides, are what happened, means slightly soluble in water. If these metal alkali halides will be bonding is takes place with water molecule means it will forming some energy will be developing is takes place, absorbing is takes place. Energy and all what happen means, sorry, energy here releasing is takes place. A new bond is forming with water molecule means energy will be releasing is takes place, releasing of energy. Energy and all what happen, releasing is takes place. So new bonding is forming with water molecule means alkyl halides. Energy and all what happen means here, releasing is takes place. As these are not as strong as the original hydrogen bonds in water, as a result, the solubility of alkanes in water will be very low. Simply you have to remember that word. Solubility and all how it is presenting means solubility will be very low is presenting. Why means? Alkyl halides are having a greater intermolecular force of attraction will be presenting there. If you want to break that bonds means more energy will be required. Right, more energy will be requiring is takes place. And automatically, if a new bonding is set up, forming is takes place between water molecule and halogen means, some energy will be releasing is takes place. So because of that reason, what happened means, haloalkanes are here, slightly it will be soluble in water molecule. So that is keep in mind. So that is about here, solubility. Next one, see, they are very, very important here. These reactions are very, very important. Reactions of haloalkanes. So what are the types of your halo, reactions of your haloalkanes is present? Chemical reactions, chemical properties. So up to this one, what you are seeing means your physical properties of water, so haloalkanes, we are seeing that. Now we are going to seeing about here. Chemical properties of your haloalkanes, we are going to seeing there. So this chemical reaction, generally how many reactions are there means totally there are three types of reactions will be presenting there. One is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Next one is elimination reactions. And third one is a reaction with the metals. Reaction with the metals. So these reactions are very, very important. Most probably they're asking for 5-mark questions and all. 5-mark or 3-mark questions or 2-mark questions and all, most probably they're asking there. Now they're asking term on exam completely MCQs only, right? But how they're asking means, so which one will be SN1 reaction, which one will be SN2 reaction like that. So that is nucleophilic substitution reactions are there. So the nucleophilic substitution reaction, which one will be the SN1 reaction, SN2 reaction will be exhibiting. So most probably like that questions and all they're asking you, right? So these are very, very important, this chemical reaction. Let us see that once. Right. First one, now we are going to see that nucleophilic substitution reactions. So nucleophilic substitution reaction. So nucleophile is nothing but generally what charge is presenting there? Electrophile is there and nucleophile is there. So what is the charge of your nucleophile? Nucleophile generally what charge they're exhibiting? Nucleophile positive. What charge they're exhibiting? Positive or negative?
Positive.
Positive charge.
Positive charge, yeah. Nucleophile ma, electrophile na? Right. So nucleophile is nothing but negatively charged species we call as nucleophile. Nucleophile is nothing but negative charged species we call as nucleophile. Positive charged species we call as electrophile. Adu mind lo ichukonga. Nucleophile is nothing but negative sign will be presenting. Electrophile is nothing but positive charge will be presenting there. Right. So totally chemical reactions, these haloalkanes, how many reactions they're exhibiting means totally there are three reactions, three types of reactions they're exhibiting. One is nucleophilic substitution reactions. Another one is elimination reaction. Third one is reaction with the metals. So let us see that first one we are going to see that nucleophilic substitution reactions. Nucleophilic substitution reactions. For example, if you have taken that alkyl halide, we have taken alkyl halide. So already diagrams is given, just see there once. So this is one nucleophile we have taken, nucleophile. So one of the nucleophile is react with the alkyl halide. Alkyl halide we have taken that. So that means carbon, hydrocarbon and one halogen will be presenting there. So that is what you call alkyl halide is taken. So nucleophile, generally this alkyl halide, how it is splitting will be takes place. Electrons are which side will be migrating is takes place. So compared to your carbon, halogen and all what happen, more electronegative element, right? Compared to carbon, halogen will be more electronegative element. So that's why what happened, this bond pair of electron will be attracting towards your halogen side. If a carbon is having what charge it will attain? Carbon will get partially, complete loss of electrons is takes place. So loss of electrons mean what charge it will attain? Positive charge it will get. Positive charge it will attain. X what charge it will attain mean minus sign it will attaining there. Partially positive and partially negative sign they are getting there. Now, here we are taking nucleophile and all what happened means compared to here X, this nucleophile is having more energy will be presenting there. So energy is nothing but simply what you're saying means nucleophiles are more electronegative element. This is more electronegative element compared to this X. X is what happened mean less electronegative element. X is nothing but less electronegative element when compared to nucleophile. So that case what happened means, so this nucleophile positive negative sign will be what happened means easily bonding is takes place with X. That means, easily bonding is takes place with the carbon atom. So therefore, reaction of how it will become means, instead of X, what will be occupying me, position will be occupied by here nucleophile. Therefore, how we are writing that compound mean C nucleophile plus X minus will be left. Simple. That is what is a substitution, Dana. Substitution. Name see there once. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Substitution is nothing but what you are saying, replacement, Dana. Substitution. Substitution is nothing but what you call replacement only, na. Substitution, yes, is nothing but what you call replacement. Yes, what will be replacing is takes place. Here, nucleophile also negative charge only present. And X also what happened? Negative charge only presenting there. X also negative charge. Nucleophile also what charge is present? Negative charge only presenting there. But when it will be replacing is takes place, you are taking nucleophile must be having more electronegative nature must be needed. Sir, ipo na eduthuradha nucleophile is having less electronegative, sir. Appo replace panna mudiyuma nu ketta na panna mudiyadhu. Right. It won't be replacing is takes place. For example, idu A person ra. A person is there, B person is there. So A person is having more energy will be presenting there. A person is having more energy is there compared to B person. So that's why what happened, B person easily it will be occupying is takes place by A. A person and all what happened, more energy will be presenting there. So that's why what happened, easily it will be occupying that B position. B and all what happened, it will be eliminating this takes place. So this is what we call substitution. So instead of myself, some other teacher, they are occupying there. That is what we call substitution. Right. So nucleophilic is nothing but negative charged particles will be occupying is takes place. Right. So that is called as nucleophilic substitution reactions. So simple, that name itself only is there. No need to confuse in that. Nucleophile is nothing but negative charged species. So the negative charged species are what happened means more electronegative element you are reacted means. Easily occupying here less electronegative element position and they will form nucleophilic substitution reactions will be takes place. Let us see that once diagram soon. Already they given. Just all of you see this example. This example, all of you just look at here once what is happening there. So first what you have taken, nucleophile is taken. Nucleophile is simply how they represent me, NU. NU minus like that they represented. This nucleophile we reacted with alkyl halide. Alkyl halide, CX like that they represented. So this compound and all what happened means, if you are a bond pair of electron is shifted towards your X side means, carbon will get partially positive and partially negative sign it will get. So you are taking nucleophile or what happened means more electronegative element we are taken. More electronegative element you are taken compared to X. So that's why what happened, easily that nucleophile will be occupying, substituting is takes place. So instead of X position, what you are substituting with nucleophile will be substituting is takes place. Therefore, the reaction how it will become means C, nucleophile will be occupying plus X minus will be lefting is takes place. So this kind of reactions are called as nucleophilic substitution reactions. Right. Nucleophile substitute agar de, where it will be substituting in less electronegative element position, what happened means more electronegative element easily it will be substituting is takes place. That reactions are called as substitution reactions. So let us see that some diagrams is given. So substitution reaction eppadi nadakkiradhu annu kettaa simply you have to remember like that. Or alkyl halide is taken. This alkyl halide, for example, react with any one of the nucleophile means. So this nucleophile are what happened? More electronegative nature compared to X. So therefore, how that reaction will become means easily X position will be replacing is takes place by nucleophile. And X what happened? It will be eliminating is takes place. Right. So this kind of reactions, what you call means nucleophilic substitution reaction. That means strong nucleophile and all what happened, it will be easily replace, substituting is takes place and it will be left at here some other less electronegative element. So these reactions are called as nucleophilic substitution reactions. Now let us see that some tabular column is given, some nucleophiles is given and what are the substituent groups is given. How this how it will be substituting is takes place. Let us see that. For example, if you are taking a reagent, you are taking sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. In that, what is a nucleophile means here? Negative charged species, OH minus. I told you that nucleophile is nothing but what charge is present in me? Negative charged. Negative charged species are called as here nucleophile, right? So here sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, if you are taken means sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, KOH you are taken means, how it will be splitting is takes place means Na plus and OH minus, K plus and OH minus like the splitting is takes place. Here what is the nucleophile means here? OH minus. Here also OH minus is the nucleophile, nucleophilic nature they are exhibiting. Right. So if you are taken this reagent, me what is a nucleophile? Me OH minus is considered as a nucleophile. So while react with the alkyl halide means what is the compound is forming me? ROH will be forming there. So that is one of the alcohol. Alcohol. OH is nothing but alcohol is the compound name. Next, same like water molecule, you are taken that. Water molecule generally what happen? Neutral in nature. So it is acting like nucleophile like that, their acting is takes place. So therefore, this compounds also will give here ROH. ROH compounds will be forming there. Next, sodium oxides is there. Sodium alkoxides will be there. So sodium alkoxides is reacted with NaOR will be there. This compound while decomposing, how it will take place? Na plus and OR minus, like the decomposing is takes place. RO minus. This RO minus while react with another alkyl halide. Simply just see there. Alkyl halide is reacted. So therefore X will be replacing with the sodium. Sodium and halogen will be left out. Therefore ROR will be forming there. ROR plus NaX will be left out. So ROR is nothing but that is called ether. So that means they taking here some reagents is taken. That reagents while how it will be, what type of a nucleophile will be forming, means these are the nucleophiles will be producing is takes place. So that nucleophile while react with alkyl halide means what will happen means. So different type of your compounds will be forming is takes place. So this is about your tabular column about your nucleophilic substitution reactions, how it will be takes place means we have to explain like this manner. Right. So what type of nucleophiles you are combining is takes place. In any compounds we will be forming. This is all important only. This tabular column also important one. Right? Alkyl halide while react with a nucleophile means different type of compounds will be forming there. So what are the compounds will be forming? These are the compounds like this tabular column. Right. So just for example purpose, this is all important one. Yes. So main thing we are going to see, just look at here. This is very, very, very important. So most probably they're asking questions and all from this concept only. What is mean by here SN1 reaction? What is mean by here SN2 reaction? These questions, compulsory question, they're asking from the board exam. Compulsory question will comes there. Either now this is only for objective questions only, MCQs only they're asking. On a compulsory question from this concept. So compared to previous concepts, what we are discussing there, but this concept and the compulsory question will comes there. SN1 reaction and SN2 reaction. Right. So just see there all of you ones. What is mean by here SN2? SN2. What is mean by here SN2 reaction? So SN2 is nothing but bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction is called SN2 reaction. Right. SN1 reaction is there. That one tomorrow class we are going to see that. So today only we have to see that SN2 reaction. So what is mean by here? SN1 means unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, that is called SN1. So S is nothing but substitution. S is nothing but substitution. N is nothing but nucleophile, nucleophilic. Nucleophilic. 2 is nothing but bimolecular. So therefore, orally, how your naming is giving this compound means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction is called SN2 reaction. SN2 reaction, bimolecular. So if it is one will be presenting means we call as unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction is called SN1. If SN2 is nothing but bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction we call as. So what is the major differences will be there? SN2 reaction and SN1 reaction. Both are, whether it is same or different. So let us see that. We will discuss that. Right. Here SN2 reaction generally what happen means, so simply what you call means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Bimolecular, so name see there, bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. SN2. 2 is nothing but bimolecular. N stands for nucleophilic. S stands for substitution reaction. So bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction is called SN2 reaction. So this SN2 reaction, what you how you are explaining means this SN2 reaction will be carried out in single step reaction. Single step reactions are called as the SN2 reaction. Single step is nothing but what happen at a time it will be forming here. Single compound, single reaction, single step. Whatever step or reaction will be completing there. But if you take an SN1 reaction means that is for two-step reaction. Two-step reactions are called SN1 reaction. SN2 is nothing but single step the reaction will be takes place. And SN2 reaction, which compounds will be participated very fastly means primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halides. Idu mind lo ichukonga. Primary alkyl halides. So primary alkyl halides will be very faster for SN2 reaction. If you are taken here, SN1 reaction we are taken means tertiary alkyl halides will be very faster. Right. We will see there that SN1 reaction tomorrow class. But today we are seeing that SN2 reaction that only. Right. Once again, I will write here. Just see where all of you want. So SN2 reaction. What is the major points are there? I mean, just see there. SN2 mechanism we can call. Or SN2 reaction like that also we can call like that. So first step what happened means this SN2 reaction, how many steps the reaction will be takes place means single step only the reaction will be takes place. Single step. So single step only the reaction will be takes place. And second point what you're saying means there is no intermediate compound will be forming. There is no intermediate compound will be forming. No intermediate compound is forming there. Intermediate compound edhume form agadu. Next one. Which compounds will be participating? Very fastly it will be undergoing for SN2 reaction means. Here primary alkyl halides. Primary alkyl halides. Primary alkyl halides will forming very fastly undergoing for SN2 reactions. SN2 reactions very fastly these primary alkyl halide will be undergoing this takes place. And this SN2 reaction mostly what configuration they are forming means inversion configuration will be forming there. Inversion configuration they are exhibiting. Inversion configuration mostly these SN2 reactions will be forming this takes place. Inversion configuration. Right. Let us see that once what are the points I told you. These points, all these points we are going to seeing there. Right. If they asking question like this, what is SN2 reaction? Which compounds will be very faster for SN2 reaction? How many steps will be involving for SN2 reaction? And SN2 reaction, what type of configuration they're forming? These Zandal 1 mark questions also take at the wipe. Right. So SN2 reactions are single step reaction. SN2 reaction, there is no intermediate compound will be forming. During the reaction, no intermediate compound will be forming. And especially SN2 reactions will be undergoing for primary alkyl halide only very fastly it will be undergoing compared to secondary, compared to tertiary alkyl halides. Next one is, these SN2 reaction mostly they will form inversion configuration they are forming this takes place. Inversion configurations they are exhibiting. So let us see that once what are the points I told you. These points only have to remember in mind. Keep in mind. Let us see that. Yeah. Just see there all of you once these equations once. This is for best example for SN2 reaction. SN2 reaction best example. So once what you are taken here, nucleophile is taken. Nucleophile is nothing but what you are taken, OH minus you are taken. So OH minus what you call means here nucleophile. So this nucleophile is reacted with CH3Cl. CH3Cl is nothing but what you call here, primary alkali halide, secondary alkali halide, this one. Carbon atom, only 3 hydrogen atoms and 1 chlorine is attaching there. Whether it is considered as primary or secondary or tertiary carbon?
Primary, sir.
Primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide we are taken. Primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide is taken. So I told you that here chlorine is what you call means here nucleophile. Chlorine is also what happened, negative sign will be presenting there. So compared to chlorine, OH group are called as a stronger nucleophilic nature will be presenting there. Compared to chlorine, OH minus what happened means stronger nucleophilic nature will be presenting there. So that's why what happened means after this nucleophile and alkyl halide is reacted means they will form a transition series will be forming there. Transition compound will be forming there. It is not considered as an intermediate compound. This intermediate compound is not. We should not say that. So they will form a transition compound will be forming there. Transition compound is nothing but at a time. So the nucleophile or newly coming nucleophile will be attacking to that alkyl halide. So attacking is takes place. How it is attacking means just look at here diagram. Already clearly they given. Just see there. First, what you have taken, nucleophile is taken, another one alkyl halide is taken. This is what is in primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide we are taken. So primary alkyl halide and nucleophile is reacted. Nucleophile is reacted. So what happened mean this nucleophile is more nucleophilic nature will be presenting there compared to chlorine. So therefore, this nucleophile will be attacking at this position of this carbon. Right. So what will happen? Let us see that. Right. So nucleophile, what happened? It will be attacking is takes place on this carbon. So one side here, nucleophile OH will be attacking there. Another side here, chlorine atom will be attacking there. So that means here OH molecule bonding and all what happened means it will become very stronger bonding is takes place with the carbon. Automatically, this carbon and chlorine bonding and all what happened means very weakly this bonding and all becoming is takes place. Why it is a carbon and a chlorine bond will become very weak means due to because of your stronger nucleophile. So OH minus what happened, very stronger nucleophilic nature will be presenting there. So that's why what happened, this nucleophile will be very strongly bonding is forming with the carbon atom. So automatically another nucleophile, what happened, chlorine atom will be slowly, slowly, the bond will become very weakness. So automatically what happened means this bond will be breaking is takes place. Carbon and chlorine bonding and all what happened means splitting is takes place, decomposing is takes place. Therefore, what happened means chlorine will be lefting is takes place and OH molecule, what happened, attacking very strongly, it will be bonding is takes place with carbon atom. So that means that OH molecule, which direction will be attacking is takes place, either same side of the chlorine atom or different side, opposite side of here, chlorine atom will be attacking there. Let us see this diagram once. Initially, compound is looking like that. So OH minus, which side will be attacking is takes place, OH minus ion you are reacted means that OH will be directing either front side will be attacking is takes place or backward direction it will be attacking is takes place. Which backward direction OH- will be attacking is takes place? Forward direction or backward direction?
Backward, sir.
Backward direction. Backward direction. What happened? This is a backward. Why it is backward direction only attacking is takes place? Why it is not acting on a forward direction like this? This is forward direction. Yeah, far- yeah, solunga. Forward direction. Chlorine.
Chlorine and OH will repel each
yes.
other.
Sir. Already chlorine is also negative charged species. OH also negative charged species. both the negative charges will be attacking on forward direction means more repulsions will be takes place. So to avoiding that repulsions, what happen means this OH minus will be attacking on backward direction. Backward direction it will be attacking, this takes place. So this configuration is called as inversion configuration. Inverse is nothing but opposite. Inverse is nothing but opposite direction. That means the nucleophile which direction will be attacking is takes place on carbon means backward direction. That means inversion direction, this nucleophile will be attacking is takes place. So that's why this configuration is called as inversion configuration. Inversion configuration, like that we are saying there, right? So these are the major points of your SN2 reaction. So once again, I will recapitulate that points. Just remember once again. So SN2 reaction, generally what you call means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction is called SN2 reaction. Yeah, yedhuku sir bimolecular nu solradhe, what are the major components is presenting means. So the rate of reaction will be depends on reactant concentration plus nucleophile also depending is takes place. Nucleophile. So the rate of reaction will be depends on reactant and another one is nucleophile. These two components will be depending is takes place. That's why that is called as SN2 reaction. Two is nothing but what you say bimolecular and so on. Bimolecular edhuku solradhan ketana, the rate of reaction will be depends on one is reactant concentration, another one is nucleophile concentration is depending is takes place. That's why we call as bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Right, adu mind lo ichukonga. Next, what are the major points are there means SN2 reaction, which alkyl halide will be very fastly is takes place? Primary alkyl halide, secondary or tertiary alkyl halide? SN2 reaction, which compounds are, which alkyl halides are very faster? Primary alkyl halides are very fastly, it will be undergoing is takes place. Primary alkyl halides. Next one, primary SN2 reaction, how many step the reaction will be takes place? How many steps the reaction is takes place? Single step or two step reaction? The reaction is takes place in
single step.
Any intermediate compound is forming during the reaction? Any intermediate compound is forming or not? No intermediate compound is forming there during the reaction. Next one. So which type of configuration is a nucleophile, which direction will be attacking is takes place to give configuration? Inversion configuration will be existing is takes place. Inversion is nothing but strong nucleophile will be attacking on reverse direction, it will be attacking is takes place with the carbon atom. That's why that configuration is called as inversion configuration we call, right? So these are the major points of this SN2 mechanism, right? So and one more point, see that, just I think time is going to over. Okay, tomorrow class we'll see there this one. What is SN1 reaction? What is the steric effects are exhibiting? These points and all tomorrow class we'll see there. Time is over. Sorry for that. I didn't see in the time. So tomorrow we'll see the remaining concepts. So thank you. Have a nice day.